This recipe has various uses. The uses are as a safe, non-toxic, antiseptic toothpaste, to avoid slow poisoning from commercial fluoride toothpastes, to indirectly reduce the fluoride-assisted absorption of aluminum, as a very inexpensive but highly effective alternative to commercial natural toothpastes, and simply to take charge of what goes into your body. The ingredients that you will need are baking soda, which is also known as bicarbonate of soda or sodium bicarbonate. As an option, peppermint oil and water. You will also need a toothbrush, and as an option, a small jar with a cover. You can use this jar only for baking soda for your oral hygiene. Labeling it will avoid any future confusion. Regarding baking soda, it is an antiseptic, which means that it fights bacteria by neutralizing the production of acids in your mouth. This also gives you some protection against infections. It also fights bad breath odor, is very inexpensive and readily available even at supermarkets. Regarding peppermint oil, although baking soda can be used alone, you can choose whether to include peppermint oil or not. Peppermint oil is antiseptic and even analgesic, which means that it relieves pain. It is usually an option if you want to mask the salty taste of baking soda with a more pleasant, minty taste and smell of peppermint oil, for example. If you want to have some added defense against gum infection, and also to, although not one of the more expensive oils, some people prefer to avoid it altogether, simply to cut costs, because cutting out peppermint oil altogether may not actually compromise their oral hygiene. Now, in cases where this ingredient is not an option for you, that is if you are pregnant, under 7 years old, or if you find the fresh cooling nature of menthol simply undesirable for whatever reason. Regarding the safety of these ingredients, unlike many commercial toothpastes, they do not include potentially harmful and slow poisoning ingredients like fluoride, as I had suggested previously. And additionally, the fact that fluoride helps in the absorption of aluminum, which is the metal most associated with Alzheimer's disease, adds to the safety benefits as well of this toothpaste. So let's begin. After flossing, wet your toothbrush, then dip the toothbrush into the baking soda jar until the crystals stick to the wet bristles. As an option, add 3 drops of peppermint oil onto the baking soda on your toothbrush. Then thoroughly brush your teeth, tongue, and gum. Now be careful. If it is your first time, you should not apply too much pressure, especially over the gum area. Applying excessive pressure may cause your gums to peel slightly. Apply more pressure only after you have gotten accustomed to this process. And then finally, rinse.
We find that afterwards we feel as though we have just come from the dentist. We could actually feel the edges of each tooth in a more pronounced way, even from the first brush. And over time I found that my teeth became whiter.
Well, thank you for watching. And if whitening your teeth is your main concern, see our other videos that are dedicated to faster working, more powerful, natural teeth whitening recipes.